Hello, grade 9 learners! This is Teacher Dali, your math galing buddy in Mathematics 9. Before we start, get your paper and pen and let us have a wonderful day of learning.
For today's lesson, solving equations involving radical expressions. At the end of this video, you will be able to solve equations involving radical expressions. Radical equation is an equation in which a variable appears in a radicand. For example, we have 3 square root of x plus 2 equals 14. Since meron tayong variable x under the radical sign, so this is an example of a radical equation. Another is 5 multiplied by the quantity of x plus 2 equals 30. In solving radical equations, we are going to consider the principle of squaring. It states that if an equation a is equal to b is 2, then the equation a squared equals b squared is also true. In solving radical equation, the following steps are suggested. For step number 1, we are going to isolate the radical on the left side by applying the appropriate properties of equality. For step number 2, combine similar terms whenever possible. Next step is we are going to remove the radical sign by raising both sides of the equation to the index of the radical. So, ito yung tinatawag natin na the principle of squaring. Step number 4 is to solve the resulting equation. And for the last step, we are going to check the solution in the given equation for a possible presence of extraneous root. Ano nga ba yung tinatawag natin na extraneous roots? When we say extraneous roots, these are numbers obtained when solving an equation that is not a solution to the original equation. Example number 1. Solve the equation square root of x equals 7. We are going to skip step number 1 and number 2. Radicals are already on the left side of the equation, and there are no similar terms to be combined. Let's move to step number 3. Remove the radical sign by raising both sides of the equation to the index of the radical. So what is our index? Correct, the index is 2. That's why we are going to square both sides of the equation. When we get the square of square root of x, the answer is x. Makakancel lang yung radical sign and yung exponent. That's why we have x. And the square of 7 is 49. So therefore, the value of x is 49. And for the last step, we are going to check the solution for a possible presence of extraneous roots. If x is equal to 49, we will just substitute the value of x to the original equation. From square root of x equals 7, it will become square root of 49 equals 7, and the square root of 49 is 7. We have now 7 is equal to 7, which is true. This means that x equals 49 is a solution. Example number 2. Solve the equation square root of x equals negative 3. Again, in this case, we are going to skip step number 1 and number 2. So let's proceed to step number 3. We are going to remove the radical sign. What is the index of the equation? Correct. The index is 2. So we are going to square both sides of the equation. When we get the square of the square root of x, the answer is x. So, makakancel lang ang radical sign and yung exponent na 2. Then, get the square of negative 3. This means negative 3 times negative 3. So, therefore, the value of x is equal to 9. Now, let us check the solution if there is a possible presence of extraneous root. If x is equal to 9, just simply substitute x to the original equation. So we have square root of x will become square root of 9. And the square root of 9 is equal to 3. 3 is not equal to negative 3. This means that this is false. Therefore, x is not a solution, meaning that 9 is an extraneous root. Since there is no other value of x, the equation has no real solution. Example number 3. Solve the equation square root of x minus 4 equals 2. In this case, we will skip step number 1 and number 2, since the radical is already on the left side of the equation and no similar terms to be combined. For step number 3, to remove the radical sign, we are going to square both sides of the equation since the index is 2. When we get the square of both sides, so makakancel lang yung radical sign and yung 2, and the resulting equation is x minus 4 equals 4. Then combine similar terms. Ang pwede natin i-combine is negative 4 and 4. And to do that, we are going to apply addition property of equality, or i-transpose lang natin yung negative 4 to the other side of the equation. So we will have x is equal to 4 plus 4. And 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. So therefore, the value of x is equal to 8. So let us check if x equals 8 is a solution or an extraneous root. By checking if x is equal to 8, substitute 8 to the variable x in the original equation. So we have x minus 4 will become 8 minus 4. And 8 minus 4 is equal to 4. So therefore, we have square root of 4 equals 2. And the square root of 4 is equivalent to 2. So therefore, 2 is equal to 2, which is a true statement. This means that x equals 8 is a solution. Example number 4. Solve the equation 3 plus 5 square root of x equals 2x. In this kind of equation, we have to isolate the radical on the left side of the equation. 5 square root of x will remain on the left side. So, kailangan yung 3 ay mailipat natin on the right side of the equation. We can apply subtraction property of equality or simply transposition. The equation will become 5 square root of x equals 2x minus 3. Since there are no similar terms to be combined, so we will skip step number 2. Let's proceed to step number 3. So the index of the radical is 2, so we are going to get the square of both sides of the equation. When we get the square of 5 square root of x, this is equivalent to 5 times 5, which is 25, and the square of the square root of x, makakancel lang yung radical sign and yung 2, so ang matitira doon is x. On the right side of the equation, so this is a square of binomial. We will get the square of the first term, so the square of 2x is 4x squared. Then twice the product of the first and the second term, 2 times 2x times negative 3 is equivalent to negative 12x. And the square of the last term, square of negative 3, is equivalent to 9. Then combine similar terms. Kailangan, 25x will be transposed to the other side of the equation. So we will have 4x squared minus 12x. Pag nilipat natin yung 25x, magiging negative 25x. Plus 9 equals 0. Then combine negative 12x and negative 25x. So the result is 4x squared minus 37x plus 9 equals 0. And to solve for the value of x, we are going to factor out our trinomial. The factors of 4x squared minus 37x plus 9 are 4x minus 1 and x minus 9. Solve for the value of x. So we have now 4x minus 1 equals 0 and x minus 9 equals 0. So we have 4x is equal to 1. Inilipat lang natin yung negative 1 kaya naging positive 1. And x is equal to 9. So here we have here the value of x, which is 9. And the other value of x is we are going to divide both sides of the equation by 4. That's why x is equal to 1/4. So the value of x are 1/4 and 9. So let us check if these are solution or extraneous roots. For checking, if x is equal to 1/4, substitute 1/4 to the variable x in the original equation. This will become 3 plus 5 square root of 1/4 equals 2 times 1/4. The square root of 1/4 is equivalent to 1/2, and 2 times 1/4 is 2/4. Then simplify, 5 times 1/2 is 5 over 2. Let us now combine 3 and 5 over 2, so that is equivalent to 11 over 2. 11 over 2 equals 1/2 is false. Therefore, x equals 1/4 is not a solution. It is an extraneous root. Let us try if x is equal to 9. So we have 3 plus 5, the square root of 9, equals 2 times 9. The square root of 9 is 3. So 3 times 5 is 15. And from here, 2 times 9 is 18. Okay, then combine 3 plus 15 is 18. So therefore, 18 is equal to 18, which is a true statement. This means that the only solution is 9. Example number 5. Solve the equation. The square root of 3x minus 5 equals the square root of x plus 19. Radicals are already isolated and no similar terms to be combined. So we will move to step number 3. To remove the radical sign, we are going to get the square of both sides of the equation since the index of the radicals is 2. So when we get the square of both sides of the equation, the result will become 3x minus 5 equals x plus 19. So we just simply cancel out the radical sign and the exponent na 2. Then combine similar terms. Ilipat lang natin yung 5 or negative 5 and x will also be transposed to the other side of the equation. The equation will become 3x minus x equals 19 plus 5. And the result is 2x equals 24. To solve for the value of x, divide both sides of the equation by 2. So the result is x equals 12. Now, let us check if x equals 12 is a solution. So we will substitute 12 to the variable x. The equation will become 3 times 12 minus 5 equals 12 plus 9. So 3 times 12 is 36 minus 5 is 31. So we have there the square root of 31. 12 plus 19 is 31. So we have here the square root of 31. Therefore, the square root of 31 equals the square root of 31 is a true statement. This means that x equals 12 is a solution. Example number 6. Solve the equation, the square root of 5x over 4 minus 8 equals 12. For step number 1, we are going to apply addition property of equality or transpose negative 8 to the right side of the equation. The square root of 5x over 4 will remain on the left side of the equation. So this will become the square root of 5x over 4 equals 2 plus 8. Simplify 2 plus 8, so we have here 10. Then, get the square of both sides of the equation. So radical sign will be cancelled out. And the result is 5x over 4. The square of 10 is 100. Then multiply 4 and 100. This will become 5x equals 400. Then divide both sides of the equation by 5. The result is x equals 80. Let us check if x is equal to 80 is a solution. Substitute 80 to the variable x in the original equation. The equation will become the square root of 5 times 80 over 4 minus 8 equals 2. 5 times 80 is 400, and 400 divided by 4 is 100. The square root of 100 is 10. So 10 minus 8 is 2. Therefore, 2 is equal to 2 is a true statement. This means that x equals 80 is a solution. Example number 7. Solve the equation the cube root of x minus 4 equals 2. Radical is already on the left side of the equation and no similar terms to be combined. So let's proceed to step number 3. To remove the radical sign, the index is 3, so we are going to raise both sides of the equation by 3. When we have the cube root of x minus 4 quantity cube, makakancel yung radical sign and yung ating exponent. So the equation will become x minus 4 and the cube of 2 is 8. Then combine similar terms, transpose negative 4 to the other side of the equation, or apply addition property of equality. The result is x equals 8 plus 4, and 8 plus 4 is equal to 12. So the value of x is 12. Now let us check if x equals 12 is a solution by substituting 12 to the variable x in the original equation. So, this will become the cube root of 12 minus 4 equals 2. 12 minus 4 is 8. So, the cube root of 8 is 2. Therefore, 2 is equal to 2 is a true statement. We can now say that x equals 12 is a solution. And now it's your turn. Get your paper and pen and do this activity. And that's for today, guys. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Again, this is Teacher Dali, your math buddy, na nagsasabing, practice makes perfect. Thanks for watching!